still inside Business Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. Thanks for staying with us. Indeed, we are going to be talking with a very renowned medical practitioner who has seen it all, especially in the medical field, and has also diversified into other areas, talking about technology. I'm talking about Dr. Tosin Ajayi. And Dr. Tosin Ajayi, let me let you into some of the activities of this personality that we're going to be talking with on our Inside Business Focus segment of the program for today. Dr. Tosin Ajayi has pioneered the advocacy for a paradigm shift in medicine and healthcare, with particular emphasis on healthcare reforms, the business of medicine and healthcare, information technology in healthcare, and the necessary capacity building for healthcare to flourish. He now preaches reorientation and knowledge transformation of our collective mentality to meet the 21st century model of human performance. He is also the managing director of Fourth Dimension Technologies Limited. In other words, like I have said earlier on, and this personality has done it all and is actually advocating for youth orientation in Africa, and talking about the NGO that has just been set up, Africa Future. Really, I want to use this opportunity to welcome Dr. Tosin Ajayi to Inside Business Africa. Thank you again for joining us.
Thank you.
Indeed, let me take my first question from the top. Nigeria used to be the pride of Africa. Indeed, at what point did we get it wrong, especially in Nigeria? Let's start from home first.
I have to look at what Africa is at the moment. You have to assess it. You have to know what it is before you can place it into the future. What do we know of Africa? Africa is the cradle of the human species. We know that now. We also know that Africa is the cradle of human development. All human beings developed in Africa before they became dispersed into the other parts of the world. We know that Africa occupies 6% of the Earth's surface. It occupies 20% of the upland surface. It occupies 15%, or we say it contains 15% of the human population. Africa is full of resources. Many resources. Is the most stable part of the world, but Africa is the poorest.
And now that you have defined where we have, where we are in Nigeria and also in Africa, let's talk about this particular NGO. What motivated you into setting up the African Future, really?
Why are we like that? What can we do to bring ourselves into the future? To make Africa not the poorest. The world is reacting to it. Everybody is reacting to it now. And we know it. And we have what it takes to be able to make Africa not the poorest of all the continents of the world. And that is what Africa Future is engaged on. Now, let me give you an example. If we don't know exactly who we are and what we are, and we accept it, and we look at it and turn the knob to be able to change it, nobody is going to do it for us. What did Wikipedia tell us? If you see Africa on Wikipedia, it says, a continent full of resources, but the poorest. You heard not too long ago what Donald Trump said about Africa. He said, all we know about is eating, sex, and thuggery. That we belong to a population that cannot develop itself. They import everything, including matchsticks. They steal their government money and bring it to United States. That is what they are. And when you want to make examples of bad governance, you use African countries. That is what we have. And you heard what David Cameron said. We are fantastically corrupt. You heard what Mark Spencer, Major James Mark, what he said. He said, Africans are not the priorities of the world. We have a lot going on in Africa. Boko Haram harassing us. We have thousands of people in bondage. The world did not react violently to that. 20-something people in other countries were killed. And the world reacted violently. And Major General James Mark said, today, Africa is not the priority of the world. So what do we do? Do we continue to stay like this and look at ourselves on a train to be disposed of by nature? No. We have gotten to a point where we can do something about this. And that is what Africa Future is all about.
Now, Africa Future, what does it entails? In other words, what bridge is it trying to build in Africa? I know you talk about the youth and the rest of them. So can you be more specific in terms of the bridge you're trying to bridge with this particular organization?
Now, I have told you that I have found out that the problem is not about training. It's not even about sending people to the university. It's not about skills. It is about underdevelopment. We do not realize in Africa how underdeveloped we are. And because we do not see ourselves as underdeveloped in a globalized world, we forget all that we need to do to develop ourselves. And we live in a globalized world. In our attempt to live in a globalized world, there's nothing we could do than to be corrupt and to prostitute. So, the first thing Africa Future wants to let Africa know is first the extent of our corruption and prostitution. And number two, that it is not what you can deter by punishing people only. Yes, we have to do that because we cannot allow it to continue freely in our environment. But we must have a strategy that centers and focuses on development. And that is what Africa Future is all about.
Courtesy of the information technology, the world is now a global village. And also, we know that the African youth, if negatively used, the technology could influence them negatively indeed. Now, how do we ensure that the technology that is flourishing all over the world and also taking the African continent by storm, how do we ensure that we get value for our youth in this regard?
Yes, that is the focus of the Africa Future. Yeah. For Africa, 50% of our population is at 19 and below. And what that means is that nature is giving us a chance The stem cells of human development is in children. If we want to fight corruption, if we want to fight prostitution, we can fight it only from a developmental point of view, and we can only fight it through children. Our concentration is going to be on youths, on children and teens, who are the future of Africa. If these people are made to not be like us, they are made to think differently from the way we think. They are made to see the world with different binoculars. They are made to see food, sex, with different binoculars. We are going to have a different population. So, what Africa's future is going to put its emphasis on is on children. How do we get our children to grow up and not to be like us? When you quantify the efforts and everything that you need in today's world of information technology, you will not be spending too much over by concentrating on the whole of Africa. And in any case, if you develop one part of Africa without developing the rest, it's going to be a little bit more difficult.
Dr. Tosin Ajayi, I know you are a businessman and you are also a medical practitioner. From your experience and your standpoint, really, what does it take to build a sustainable business, especially in the continent like Africa?
Nigeria and other African countries, we behave the same way. We are all constricted in the little choices we make. We are constricted. We make very little choices. We make only little choices for ourselves. We have not seen the world as it should be. We have not seen the multiple choices that lie ahead because we have very little capabilities. So, there's no point looking at Nigeria alone.
Now let's talk about viability and vulnerability to environment and the rest of them. How do you identify business opportunities in Africa, and indeed how do you also measure their viability, especially before you go into them, and then so that you can actually get return on investment on these things?
Yeah, FIRST Foundation gave birth to Africa Future. It's our activities in FIRST Foundation that brought us to Africa Future. Because, like I told you from the beginning, all the efforts was on development of healthcare. But we find out that all this sectorial development cannot happen unless you change the man behind it. You can't. The same man who is in politics is the same man who is in business. And it's the same man who is in medicine, and it's the same man who is in the courts, and it's the same man who is the teacher, and it's the same man who is the fisherman. So, what do you do? You cannot sectorally develop. You have to look at that bond that binds everybody, and that is the development of the population. And if we are going to look at the development of the population, and we look at how to improve that department and bridge that gap to a level where other things can be done, we are going to have a better future.
Now, when you say African future, we want to believe that this whole concept is African-wide kind of initiative. Now, I mean, are there specific countries that you've taken up, and or are there some specific countries that you have actually seen made some impact in terms of the project itself, and that you want to explain also led us into how it has fared?
Nobody was thinking at looking at corruption and prostitution from developmental level before. It's going to be a challenge to convince the people that we have to look at development. That's a challenge. And how do we look at development? What do we do when we look at development? Now, the other challenge is that in a totally corrupt place, it's very, very difficult to implant a new seed. Very, very difficult. But we cannot look on like this. We look at things differently and we think differently. But I am convinced that unless we look at corruption and prostitution among us from developmental point of view, there's not much we can gain.
Finally, I know that we are talking about the African future and also the project that you're actually piloting, and also the executive chairman of that African future. Now, but Africa is bedeviled with what we call corruption, and that has actually been the bane of development of this continent. Could you share your own opinion or your take on the issue of corruption and the African continent, and how do we ensure that we get out of this mess?
Oh, the present administration has embarked on stemming down corruption, and you could see the genuineness in their actions. It's a very difficult task. A very, very difficult task. The only thing I could always add is, as they are doing this, they have to look at strategies that we have to take to prevent future corruption and prostitution. Corruption is far, far larger than stealing government money. Planting the wrong people all over the place is even worse than stealing the money. Compromising all the indices of excellence is the highest level of corruption. When you compromise all the indices of excellence, what can you do right? Before the project is advertised, you already know who you are going to give it to. Before the person is appointed and you are advertising, you already know who is going to take it. And we all know all this. And this happens every day in our lives. How can we ever have the best performance among us? It's not going to be possible. So the government should extend the strategy. We should know the extent of corruption. Or do we want to add the fact that what corruption has done to the female sex among us? Our female sex have been made to think that the most important parts of their bodies are their sexual organs. And that's it. And this is what they promote daily. And that is 50% of our population not really attending to productivity. How much do we appreciate good attributes among our women, apart from looking at them as sexual tools. Corruption. Corruption is a big issue. And if we want to face it, we can only face it developmentally.
Well, thank you indeed, Dr. Tosin Ajayi, for sharing your thoughts with us today on the project African Future. And I know very well that you have succeeded in many other endeavors. You will also succeed with this and make the necessary impact that you are trying to make. Thank you very much indeed for sharing your thought with us today.
Thank you.
Well, we'll be speaking with Dr. Tosin Ajayi of the African Future, and he's been doing a lot to ensure capacity building within the community of African youths, and also that doing that, teaching Nigeria how to do things right in one way or the other. Stay with Inside Business.